Hello and good evening, this is Ruth Pozuelo from Curval.com, and it is finally time for DAX Fridays again. Today, as promised, I'm going to go through the calculate expression. And as you can see, it is written part one. And the reason for that is because calculate is a very simple expression that does very complex things. And I don't want to explain everything at once because it could be too much. So I think it's better to build up on it. So today we will go through calculate. Next Friday we will talk about filter. And then we will go back again to calculate to build up on it and build really, really cool expressions. Without more delay, let's go at it. Okay, so what we have here is the north wind data source that is available for free, and what we're going to do is look at the sales of the products that are on that database. So let's just start by just putting in the total sales column. This is how the table looks like. It just says product ID, order ID, and then we have a calculated column that calculates the total sales. So if you just want to know the sales for the entire data set, we get it here. So let's say that this is Swedish crowns and it's 1 million Swedish crowns. Excellent. Now, let's say that we want to know the sales for the product. Per product. So to do that, we would go into the product table, make it a little bit bigger, and then again bring in the total sales column. And what it does is it is exactly the same column, but this one has no filter applied. And this one has the product name applied as a filter, and that's why we get a different result. Okay. On a previous video, we've gone through this behavior, and let's try to do. I've always tell you that it's a good practice to have not to use the columns as measures, but to create measures. So let's create the sum of total sales equal to the sum of order details and then total sales. It is in the wrong table, so let's move it to order details. That's where we will store all the measures. So these two, they do exactly the same thing. The reason for having a sum measure is in case these total sales would change names. Okay, so we hide this and let's do these without decimals. And it, of course, is giving us exactly the same results it should. So delete that. So now what happens if we use calculate to calculate the sum of products? Let's do that. So we write calculate total sum total sales. And then we write calculate. And this is the way calculate works. You need to have an expression. So you cannot have a column. If I would say, I want to write here the column order details total sales, it doesn't show up. Do you see? The only thing that shows up are our measures, because you need to have a measure, an expression. In the first part of the calculation. So we will add our measure, which was the sum of total sales. And we do nothing else. We just create the calculate formula and then we move it to where we want to have it, which is the order details column. So let's see what this does. It gives us exactly the same results. Okay. So what is calculate good for? You might be asking yourself. Well, calculate starts becoming really useful when you start adding filters to it. Okay. So every time you would like to calculate something based on something else, for example, calculate the number of, this is our cheeses. So calculate the sales for the queso cabrales. By the way, this is an Asturian cheese from Spain where I come from. So it's quite cool that it's on the database. Anyhow, let's say we want to know the number of sales only for queso cabrales. Well, you can do that, of course, with a filter, but you can do that with calculate. So let's give it a go. Calculate with filter. And then we will write calculate. Again, a measure. You won't be able to have columns here. And now we said filter product's name is equal to queso cabrales. Now we take this one, move it to where we want to have it, and we want to have 0. So what is this going to do? What this actually does is what I like to call the Henry Ford behavior. I don't know if you know about the story, but it says that Henry Ford once said that, okay, my customers can buy any car they want, in any color they want, as long as it is black. So calculate is doing exactly the same thing here. You're saying, I don't care what filter you have here, I am going to return the sales for the queso cabrales only. So if you look here, it is 11,000, and that's what it shows on every row. Okay, so this is very powerful, and we will see later on why. But it is important to understand that what it does is it ignores any other filter that is available, and it just gives you the answer that you told him to give. So the car will be black, period. Now the question is, it is ignoring the product name filter that is here in place, right? But if I would add a year column, what is it going to do? Let's sort by it so it will be easier to see. And this is quite interesting now. Calculate here is actually giving us two different values now. 4,000 and 6,000. Of course, these together will be the 11,000 that we had before. But this time is filtering by year. So it is a very important behavior to understand from the calculate column. Let's go back here. So we said ignore the product name filter, but we didn't say ignore the year filter. So we will still get the result for the sales queso cabrales 1998 to 1997. Okay. So let's build this up a little bit more. For example, can we say to calculate, give me the total sales and ignore all product names, not only queso cabrales. So give me total sales for all product names. Let's build that. New measure. Calculate with all product. To do that, we will write calculate, remember again, an expression, nor a column. And now we are going to use an expression that I haven't introduced before, but it is like intuitive, and it's called all. So what all does is just filters by everything, right? Which is exactly the behavior that we want. We will go through all later on, but it is such an intuitive expression. So let's have a filter product name. Okay, so we're telling calculate now, please ignore all product names and give me the sales for all products, no matter what filter is in place. Let's look at that. So, and how cool is this? So the total product sales we have here, let's take out the year first so we can see it. So this is the total sales. Now it is completely ignoring the product names. So it's again doing the Henry Ford. I don't care what you're asking me. I'm going to deliver you a black car on every line. But if we again bring back the year, because we didn't say ignore the year, it will actually filter by it. And then if we just sort this up, this is for 1998 and this is for 1997. So really cool, right? So why is this useful? Well, one of the easiest way to demonstrate why this is useful is, for example, if we would like to calculate percentage of sales for every product. So let's do that just as an example, because what we need is really to divide this value by all sales, right? To calculate the percentage. Let's take away the year again to make it easy to see. So the percentage of sales, of total sales, it would be this value, the sum for this product divided by all products. So let's calculate that. Percentage of sales. And that would be 3 sum divided by all products. Let's get that, put it in the table that we want to have it, and this is a percentage, and we don't want to have any decimals. And now let's see what happens. Here we have it. So now it's giving us the percentage of total sales. If we add year, and then we have for 1998 and 1999. So useful, right? So this is all for today. Next Friday, we will be talking about all again, and we will be talking about filter. Once we have introduced that, we will go back to calculate and create more complex expressions. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know by liking it. If you have any questions or doubts, just let me know in the comment box or any of the social channels that are listed below. And subscribe. I publish videos every week, both on DAX, on dashboards, and on Power Query. Have a great evening. Bye.